My name is Keely Wolter, K-E-E-L-Y, W-O-L-T-E-R, and I am an accent and dialect coach.
I feel like a lot of people, when they hear that, they'll be like, how on earth do you get into that field? What made you go into that field?
I was an actor. I was an actor.
That makes sense.
And then I always kind of had a talent or a desire to do accents. It was always like the most fun part of it for me. So then I started doing that and it just like took over my life.
And that's your full-time job now?
Yeah.
Helping other actors,
yes.
People in TV media, including myself. I'm a former student. So it's nice to see you again.
Yes. No,
so what accents do you do? Accents from all over? You teach people from all over the world?
Yes. Yeah, so I teach actors accents for roles that they're doing, you know, to sound like they're from a different place. But I also work with people who are from all over and then they want to sound maybe more American or more standard American, which is just this kind of idea of non-regional speech.
Right, that's the goal, I guess. If you want to be under the radar, fly under the radar in terms of your accent.
Under the radar, it's just like you want to communicate information, but you don't want people to be distracted thinking like, oh, where's she from? What's
okay.
She, you know, you're trying to get the information and not the accent across is usually the goal with that.
Okay, so we were talking about you work with actors and you were just telling me how cool is it that the movie Fargo or the show, the TV series Fargo,
yeah.
Currently, you work with some of the actors, they reached out to you.
Yeah, so some of the actors auditioning.
Okay.
Yeah, so a lot of the actors who are auditioning, so I'm not like officially affiliated with the Fargo TV show, but because I'm at like an internet presence of Minnesota accent knowledge, when actors are auditioning for that out in LA, they'll contact me, we'll do like a Zoom session, we'll work on some of the sides and like put it together. It's really fun.
Do they find it challenging to get the accent down?
Yes, actually. Actually, like, I've worked with several actors on it and they're like, this is really hard because it's just not an accent that you have in your ear. You know, sometimes you can be like, oh, I can figure out kind of a Southern accent because I've
right.
heard a lot of Southern accents. And a Minnesota accent isn't as culturally prominent. It's a little more niche. And so getting into it and being, and a lot of what I hear from those actors is like, is this can't be right. You can't say this like that. And I'm like, no, we do. That's how we say it. And it's, you know, it's great. We
can
love
you
it.
Give me some examples of what they're like? Oh gosh, what are you saying?
I know, oh gosh. I'm trying to think of the line. Because I was working with, I shouldn't be touching this.
That's okay, that's all right.
I was working with, one of the actors I was working with is British. And so she's trying to do an American accent and then put the Minnesota accent on top of it. And a lot of those, she was like, this can't be right. And it was like that, oh gosh, like, oh, ah, that sound. And she was like, this sounds absolutely bonkers. And I was like, but it's right. It's
right.
Right. Yeah.
Oh boy. So let's talk about the Minnesota accent. What makes it quintessential? I mean, we're a melting pot. We have all different kinds of cultures and people here. But when people think Midwest or Minnesota, they think of that long O's,
yeah.
The A's. So what makes it that? What region, and is it different in the state? Tell me what you know about it.
I'll tell you. Let me tell you what
let
I know.
Let me tell you.
No, so when people think of like a Minnesota accent, what they're thinking of is that very like white, Eurocentric, you know, Euro immigrant influenced accent that has like those long O's, those flat A's, that very like Fargo accent that we're thinking of, and that's what's in our heads as the Minnesota accent. And obviously there's lots of other accents here,
right.
Or lots of versions of that accent. The accent that you hear in the Twin Cities is different than the accent you hear on the Iron Range, you know, or in like Southern Minnesota farming communities, but there are similarities to it. The most prominent feature of the Minnesota accent is that long O, which we all know.
Right.
All, We all know it, right?
It's whenever boats, coats.
Yes, boats and coats.
Boats
but
and
I
coats.
Always think like of saying the name of our state. If someone asks you where you're from, you can't say it without doing the Minnesota. Oh, you have to do that. Well, Minnesota. I'm from Minnesota.
Minnesota.
And
sure.
I worked hard and long to like have that Minnesota, like
right.
like a rounder, more open O. But that Minnesota, that tight, long O, is such a signifier of this accent specifically.
Because we say O, it's yes. straight O.
So we do the O as a monophthong.
Okay.
Which means one vowel sound. So a monophthong is like an E is a monophthong because there's only one sound. And we make our O into a monophthong. So we say O. Whereas in a general American accent or other accents in the United States, the O is a diphthong. It has two sounds. So it goes O, O. And when I teach it to Minnesotans, who are doing other accents, I'm like, it's the O that you say when you are having an idea and you're like, oh.
Yes.
And you take longer to get there. But we do it like in the Minnesota accent, it's a very efficient O. You know, like you get there fast, you move along, you're like, oh, oh, it just goes because there's a tightness.
Right.
Yeah.
It's all like right here. Very nice.
It's very,
very
nice.
Nice.
It's very nice. It's a little tight.
So yeah. Why do we have, so when you think Southern accent, they have this long draw thing. Why in Minnesota are we the O's and the E's? Is it what region are we talking? Is it Norwegian? Is it Swedish? Is it a blending? Is it a?
Yeah, so there are a lot of theories on this and the research is, you know, a little inconclusive from what I have gleaned. And I'm sure there's more than I know. Because initially it was really thought that it was a lot of Scandinavian influence that made this happen. And you can think a little bit about like Scandinavian influence when you hear like the bounciness in the accent, where you get that sort of, I'm going up and down and I'm talking like this. And it has a sort of that feel, you know, that melody to
right.
it.
Sing-songy.
Da, 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 yeah. A little sing-songy. But the O's and the E's are actually really similar to like Irish or Gaelic language influences.
Okay.
And so, I read something recently that was like, no, there's actually more of that influence here than we thought previously in our speech. And I thought it was pretty interesting because I have taught Irish accents to Minnesotan actors. And Minnesotan actors can pick up Irish accents pretty quickly because some of those sounds are very similar. Whereas when I'm trying to teach it to non-Minnesotan actors, it's like a little more difficult to grasp
Ireland.
Those vowels.
So if you go Minnesota, like Northern Minnesota, Ely, Brainerd, Iron Range versus Southern Minnesota, can you tell the difference of where they're from?
Sometimes.
Okay.
Like I have some signifiers I can pick out sometimes with people. Like as you get more rural or further north, you'll hear a different thing with the THs than you do. You get some more of that dem, dare, does, that kind of thing that you don't have as much in the south. There's some ways that people say things that is a little different. Like as we all know, Minnesota is a duck, duck, gray duck.
Right.
State.
You heard it here, folks.
Like it's
yes.
like seriously, like we're like a little island.
Right.
Of duck, duck, gray duck in a sea of duck, duck, goose. And I learned a couple years ago, the Iron Range is duck, duck, goose.
Interesting.
And they're an island within an island. You know, where there's like a lot of their own, because that community was very like insular for a while, that they developed a lot of their own speech patterns there that are slightly different from
right.
outside of that area.
And that's where you learn it. And then it continues. You have families, you stay there, and then
yes.
it continues on and on and on.
Yes.
If you don't
yes,
move
yes.
away, I guess. That's where people usually realize they have an accent when you move away.
Yes.
You're like, oh gosh. Oh gosh.
I know, and we hear all the Minnesotan, we're like, oh, it's so Minnesotan, or not, or
right.
Or maybe we don't. Maybe a lot of us up here are like, I don't have an accent, you know? I don't.
That's what I said to my boss when she sent me to you. I was like, what you talking about?
I don't have an accent. But then when you go, like, if you go to the South, they won't say, oh, you're from Minnesota. They'll say, you're not from here.
Yeah.
You're from
you don't
somewhere
say y'all.
Else.
Yeah. Let's talk about our friends in Sconeyland, Wisconsin. Do they have something different than what's going on in Minnesota?
So or are you a Wisconsinite?
I grew up in Minnesota, and then I moved to Wisconsin.
Yeah.
So I'm a tweener. That's why I was like, is there a difference? Because there has to be some.
There is. There is a difference. There are differences, and you can hear them. But they're subtle, and they're a lot of people wouldn't be able to tell the difference. So there are big similarities, like in the northern Midwest, there's a lot of these flat vowels. Like I remember the sentence I made you do.
Oh,
that
oh
was
boy.
Like, I got my boss a cup of hot coffee.
Cup of hot coffee.
Yeah, I got my boss a cup of hot coffee, where we had that really flat, that ah sound, which is really similar, like Wisconsin, Minnesota.
Right.
We love to do, Chicago does a lot of that, where it's that instead of like, I got my boss a cup of hot coffee.
I remember, it was so hard. I still would struggle. Yes. It just feels wrong. It feels wrong. Coffee, not coffee,
because
right.
That's something else. That's a different accent.
That's like Boston.
That's a different accent. But like when you talk to the people in Wisconsin versus in Minnesota, everybody has opinions about what's different. And one of the things that I've noticed in talking to people is how you say the name of the state of Wisconsin, like, gives it away.
Wisconsin. Wisconsin.
Wisconsin.
Wisconsin.
But someone once told me it was the people who say Wisconsin or Wisconsin.
Gosh, I don't even know who was right.
Who's right? I know. Yes. But there are those differences, and I tend to hear a little bit more of the TH thing as you like move across Wisconsin, where those THs get kind of deadened. Or like turn into D's a little bit more. But again, like they're very similar. They're very similar. But there's loads of differences, and I'm sure like people have
what's the biggest
massive
one?
Massive opinions.
The biggest differentiator for you? Is it the caffeine one?
The hot coffee. I got my boss a cup of hot coffee.
Yeah.
That one's like a big similarity to me.
Okay.
I think the biggest difference is Minnesotans tend to tighten and close their mouths more. So we tend to keep our teeth really close together. And we have a little bit of like a
creepy smile.
A little creepy smile. No, but it's like if you start to do that, you have that tightness here. You have a tightness in the tongue. And Wisconsin tends to do a lot of the same sounds, but open their mouth a little wider.
Interesting.
Yeah. No, if you want to practice your Minnesota accent or not your Minnesota accent, we definitely had the O one, right? I was making you say like...
Something about boat.
The boat. It was like...
It's practicing the O versus the O.
Yeah, it was O. It was like, let's go home and get on the boat, I think is what it was.
Let's go home and get on the boat.
Let's go home and get on the boat.
There's one.
Which, if you wanted to soften your Minnesota accent, you would say, let's go home and get on the boat.
With the diphthong.
Yeah, do your homework right now.
Let's go home and get on the boat. Oh, gosh. All right, we're signing up for another round of lessons.
Right now. And then we did have, I got my boss a cup of hot coffee.
Okay, I got my boss a cup of hot coffee.
That's close.
I'm getting better.
It's very
I'm sweating.
Close.
I'm getting really
do your homework. Do your homework.
All right. I'll post your info if people,
fabulous.
Local schools want to reach out.
Yeah.
Practice their. Anything else you want to add that I missed or that we didn't discuss about the accents and
I'm
region?
I'm trying to think. We would be remiss if we didn't talk about bag.
Oh, the bag. Big.
Right? Big.
Big. Oh, yeah, I had to practice bagel with you because I'd say bagel.
Bagel. It's like this is, so this one's a very distinctive, like, Minnesota
only
sound. Big. Which big. I'm saying it right now, but if you're not from Minnesota, you're not going to know what word I'm even saying.
Yeah.
So we say big, it's that A gets so tight instead of bag.
Oh yeah, that just bag. I feel like it's word vomit.
Bag. It's
bag,
but it's all bag. About this again, you can see it when you say it big, that your mouth is like tiny. Your mouth has to be tiny to do it. And gosh. Tight and in that weird like Minnesota nice smile. Yeah.
Big. That's so funny. Bag. That seems weird too to my it just is foreign
bag,
to my mouth.
Bag. Yes.
Bag.
But it's one where if you go to different parts of the country and you say, oh, can I get a bag? And people will not.
Pardon me?
Excuse me? Like, what are you saying? But that's that E, that really tight A is another one that's a huge signifier of our accent.